LMU. Introduction. In the introduction, we would like to give you an overview of the licensing workflow, give you information about the installation and update of the software, show you an email content of a license entitlement, inform you about the license certification with Dongles and the Trusted Platform Module TPM chip, give you information about the support of not only physical, but also virtual environments, to introduce you to the help documentation of the tool, and finally, inform you what is new in version 2.6. Let's start with the licensing workflow, from the order to the activation of a license. This is an overview about the licensing workflow, from the order to the activation in the respective customer site on a product or on an engineering machine for an individual engineering tool. The regional company orders and purchases the license through the regional SAP system or the solution partners via iMall. The license management system LMS in the headquarters creates automatically an entitlement and emails the information to the license receiver in the regional company or in the solution partner. The major tasks of a license management system LMS are license generation, license management, license reporting and product definition. It offers an overview of all products, versions, options and handling of license updates. The entitlement in the email contains, among others, the customer site identification CSID. Each installation at a customer site needs a valid license and is identified by the customer site ID, which is a unique identification generated in LMS. The product information, the entitlement identification, and the list of licenses or activation identifications in quantity. At this point, an operator, in our case an engineer responsible, can use the content of the email and activate the license or licenses on the customer site machine or on the engineering PC for a specific engineering tool by using the license management utility, the LMU application. The LMU offers two ways to perform the licensing tasks. The online workflow. The online workflow requires a connection to the back office license server through the internet or intranet. And the offline workflow. This procedure is required when on the target computer no internet connection is allowed, as for example on a customer PC. License management utility offers three types of license activation. On trusted store where the license is bound to server hardware components. As certificate where the license is assigned to a USB micro dongle CMD04 or CMD06 using a certificate file. And a second option also is certificate, where the license is assigned to an internal trusted platform module chip. Instead of using an external USB dongle, it is possible to use a dedicated microcontroller designed to secure hardware trough integrated cryptographic keys in the machine. Please note, in cases where additional options are required that are not covered by LMU, please contact customer support. As next, let's have a look how to install management license utility and how future update versions are notified. The LMU licensing tool is used in various products and different engineering tools in Siemens infrastructure. The installation of the tool varies by product and can be part of the overall product installation or it is required to be installed separately. Either way, the LMU installation software is included in the product software release package where LMU is used, in the folder LMS. The LMS folder contains the setup file to execute the installation process. For Siemens employees, the program is also available in the software center. Please consider the installation instructions of the product where LMU is used. With the installation, a shortcut is created on the desktop to allow to start the license management utility application. And with this version, a new icon is introduced. In the help documentation, under the section Introduction, information are available about the general system requirements. The LMU supports the Siemens software updater. The user is notified about the updated versions of the product, critical fixes or important announcements without the need of running the LMU application. A pop-up notification from the Siemens software updater appears from the right corner of the PC, whenever there is new software updates available and required to be installed in your machine. This notification enables the user to view, download and install the latest software updates available for the LMU application. Please note, the software update notification requires an internet connection. In case of an offline system, the update procedure needs to be executed manually and it requires also an up-to-date .NET framework version. As you might remember, in the session licensing workflow, we explained that the license management system in the headquarter creates automatically an entitlement and emails the information to the license receiver. Now in this session, let's have a look what the content of such an email is. In this example, the purchaser has ordered a DeZego CC license. As a result of the order, the purchaser will receive an email with the following information: the email receiver address, the customer site identification, entitlement identification. Each license email contains one entitlement ID and represents the license model in the product that a customer has bought with quantity. Each entitlement can contain one or more products. In our example, the entitlement contains 5 product articles. Each article has an own Siemens product number, an own product article with version information and quantity, and an own activation identification. DeZego CC is a brand and based on the product GMS, Global Management Station. Therefore, all product article starts with the product name GMS. In the following information, the entitlement ID and the activation IDs will play the main role for the activation of licenses. Licenses can be assigned to devices like USB dongles or a trusted platform module chip, which is built in the machine. Let's have a closer look to these devices. Dongles are USB devices which are used for securing certificate licenses. When a license is assigned to a dongle certificate, it allows moving license rights between hosts. This version of LMU supports 2 types of micro dongles: the green-colored CMD.04 dongle. Each dongle has a 10-digit ID number. Next to the picture you find also the SSN order number. The CMD.04 dongle will be replaced by the new red-colored, driverless CMD.06 dongle, which is also identified by a 10-digit number. Also here, next to the picture you find the order number. Please note, this dongle is supported from the LMU version 2.4. Detailed information about the dongle and its key identifications can be viewed directly from the LMU by selecting Settings in the Stack pane and Dongle Overview in the Navigation pane. The third-party embedded tool from the dongle provider in the View pane shows in this example 2 micro dongles with the different 10-digit key identifications. And the versions of the dongles, in this case both dongles are from version 4. The embedded tool offers, in addition to the Sentinel keys, also information about products, features, sessions, etc. Of course, the display of this information is only possible when a dongle or dongles are plugged in the machine where LMU is running and whether the dongles are being recognized by the tool. The LMU tool shows also the dongle identification when selecting the radio button dongle in the stack pane activatable items, under the point activation ID in the navigation pane. Also here, the identification numbers of the 2 dongles are presented. Please note, unsupported dongles are not displayed at this point. Another, more secure way to use certificate licenses is by assigning the license to a trusted platform module chip, which is built in the machine. With LMS version 2.5, we released a new way to activate licenses and bind them to the TPM Trusted Platform module. TPM is an international standard for a secure crypto processor, a dedicated microcontroller designed to secure hardware through integrated cryptographic keys. The term can also refer to a chip conforming to the standard. newer computers are being sold with a built-in TPM chip. The license management system requires at least TPM chip version 2.0. By the way, also the installation of the operating system Windows 11 requires version 2.0. Any application can use a TPM chip for protection and enforcement of software licenses. This is the feature we are using in the license management system. Digital rights management. Windows Defender, Windows Domain Logon, etc. Also here, in activatable items and activation ID, the LMU shows the corresponding key ID number of the chip for a valid TPM chip version. With this prerequisite, it is also possible to select the radio button for activating a license or licenses. Without valid TPM chip version, the option is grayed out. The version of the PTM chip can be checked on the computer. In the Windows, search Enter TPM and click on Security Processor icon. In the window that opens, click on Device Security and Security Processor Details. The specification version must be at least 2.0. In this session, we would like you to inform that the license management system supports also virtual machines in a virtualization platform. License management solution supports not only physical machines, but also computer in virtual environments. Regarding supported virtual environments of LMS, is important to know that we differentiate between trusted and untrusted virtual environments. We consider virtual environments as untrusted if they don't recognize copied virtual machine correct, for example VMware workstation, which asks client if the virtual machine has been moved or copied. This is not trustworthy. Depending on a trustful environment or not, the operation mode indicator of the graphical user interface displays the state of license management system's operation mode as full or restricted. The operation mode full is displayed when full functionality is available on trusted store as well as certificates for trusted environments with locally running license server. When the operation mode restricted is shown, no trusted store license can be activated or deactivated. However, remote use of licenses are possible as the licenses concerned are installed on a trusted environment. For more information about physical and virtual environments, firewall settings and general configurations, please refer to the help document of the LMU tool in the chapters Server-based licensing and the subchapters. As usual today, this tool also offers a help documentation. In this learning, we cannot show all workflows and features that the LMU tool offers. That would go too far. In this session, we would like to introduce you to the help documentation where detailed information can be found. The help documentation is available in the LMU tool in the menu. For further and detailed information, please refer to the help of the LMU. We reached the last chapter of the introduction, with news in version 2.6. In the help document in section General and Chapter New in LMU, all news per version back to version 2.0 are listed. Various helpful improvements are listed and described in this release. Please, take a moment to look at these news.